प्रभु जय सीताराम भगवान। दिस वेरी ब्यूटीफुल संडे मॉर्निंग वी कम टू यू इन कन्फाइंस ऑफ योर होम एज वी जॉइन टुगेदर दिस मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल डे इन संसार। वी ग्लोरिफाई द नेम ऑफ भगवान, वी सिंग हिज प्रेजेस, वी सीक हिज मर्सीज। दिस मॉर्निंग एज ऑल ऑफ आवर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स इन द वेस्टर्न हेमिस्फीयर mark the occasion of Mother's Day, we join together with you, the wonderful devotees of the Krishna Mandir, and indeed wonderful devotees looking on, as we join together in paying tribute to our mothers who are here with us physically, those mothers who are not with us any longer, as well as paying tribute to the Divine Mother, that Universal Mother who loves us unconditionally. This morning, as we join together in satsang, let us all glorify the Divine Mother. Let us sing the glories. Let us seek her blessings. As we clasp our hands, close our eyes, we go within. We go within and realize the divinity within each and every one of us. We realize that wonderful divine energy, that Shakti, that permeates our entire being. And as we do so with a sense of love, with a sense of purpose, let us all seek the divine protection of this universal mother. Hari Om.
Thank you. Oh, नमो नमो दुर्गे सुख कारिणी नमो नमो मम्बे भाई मनी तुम्हारी माजन की नुमा भटी।
This morning we come to you in a very different but unfortunately not unfamiliar environment, and that is virtually. Mother's Day last year was celebrated differently, and this year even more so, because of the restrictions that have to be imposed as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. It is said by one century that if you love your mother and you do not live in the same household as she does, then the best gift that you can give your mother on this Mother's Day is to stay at home and to keep her safe. And that is a very, very difficult thing to do, because by nature we are gregarious individuals. We long for that hug, we long for that touch, we long for that emotion. And so it is a very difficult time to ask a child or children to stay away from their mother because they love them. But brothers and sisters, those of you who are viewing on, as difficult and as tough as that decision is, the risks of not doing so are glaringly even greater. Yesterday we had the very, very tragic situation of being told, and I will not say the word cases, but that the number of individuals who have been diagnosed with COVID-19, the number of mothers and daughters and sisters and grandmothers and aunts, the number of fathers and sons and brothers and grandfathers who have been diagnosed yesterday is 402. Seven more of our relatives would have passed, and the total number now in excess of 200. And those statistics are what we know of, so the risks of not staying away are even greater. So this morning, as difficult as it is, I join with others in encouraging you to stay away, to stay at home, unless it is absolutely essential to go out. And if you go out, to wear the masks in a proper way, to sanitize, and most importantly, to not congregate. I repeat that, to not congregate. Our situation is dire. Our nurses and doctors and all of the supporting medical personnel are being stretched to their very limit. Our physical resources and hospitals are also being stretched. And if these appeals do not resound in our heart and in our mind to change our behavioral pattern, then I don't know what will. So I urge you today, as we celebrate Mother's Day, to heed the plea and to stay away from your mothers and your grandmothers if you truly love them. This will not be forever. But as was said, we need to take a drastic measure to change the trajectory upon which we are right now. Feeling which, we will soon be looking at 1,000 patients a day or more who are infected by this virus. So let us not come to that number, but let us know what we have to do at this point to change. Enough of COVID-19. Mother's Day, as we join together in celebration, is something that has been over the years commercialized. So we feel that this particular second Sunday in the month of May must attract a commercial response, or some sort of extraordinary response, in the tribute that we pay to this wonderful individual in our lives, Mother. What does our tradition speak to us about this? For most of us who are Hindus, one of the first Vedic prayers that we learn, that is recited on almost every occasion that we come together in puja or in satsang, Tvameva mata cha pita tvameva, Tvameva bandhu sisthika tvameva, Tvameva vidya dravinam tvameva, Tvameva God, you are mother. You are mother. This morning we just sang the verses of Durga Chalisa. We not too long ago emerged from the celebration of that wonderful period of Navratri, where we worshipped during the month of Chaitra, the divinity in the form of the universal mother. And we sometimes ask ourselves, what is the purpose and intent when we look at the mandir and we look at the murtis around us? What is the purpose and intent of worshipping God in the form of the Divine Mother? Well, I must say that in my own personal belief, that our rishis and munis, unquestionably, the very wise persons. For they recognize that each and every one of us have been given birth to by a mother. The mother is the pivotal rock upon which our societies are built. We often hear the cliche saying, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world, and sometimes we wonder, what does that mean? I was very strongly reminded yesterday and today by my Dulhan about the power of a mother in the home, and not only by her words but by her example. And it struck me that when the Vivasanskar is being performed, we refer to the Dulaha as Vishnu Bhagwan and we refer to the Dulhan as Lakshmi Mata, but sometimes we get lost in understanding what that really means. The mother in the home is indeed that light of the home, that light which if present and which if nurtured removes all darkness from the home, both literally and figuratively. The mother in the womb provides that strength for all, not only the children. She provides that example, that love, that compassion, that fortitude, that courage, and yes, that sense of discipline and forthrightness when it is required, and it is often required. And sadly, when the mother in the womb is not there, either physically or by the example and behavior that is performed or expected, then many things go wrong in that home. The home is really a place of darkness, of sadness, and of melancholy. And so it is that the mothers of the home provide a very powerful energy that allows that home, that allows the children, that allows the father of that home to prosper and to glow and to be uplifted, unquestionably. Look at any happy home, as they would say, and most present in that home is the shining, powerful figure of the mother. No disrespect to fathers. When we look at this powerful physical example for ourselves, we draw the analogy into our traditions which speak to the universal mother. And we consider all of our scriptures, not one, not a particular one, but all of them, unequivocally, most powerfully entrenched in our scriptures is the presence of the divinity in the form of the feminine aspect, in the form of the mother. None more so than Ramchandranas, Durga Saptashakti, and other powerful texts and scriptures. And our rishis and munis in their wisdom recognize that if we as individuals on this physical journey can relate in such a meaningful way to the love and power of an earthly mother, then by that example and that relation, we would or should be able to understand the love that the universal mother, that supreme Brahm, would have for all of us. And that is the beauty of our scripture. Because every child can relate in some form or fashion, in a mean, to the love of a mother. That mother who stands as a flower, as the song says, in the midst of thorns. That mother, as the song says, who sacrifices her sleep for the well-being of her child so that her child can sleep. That mother, as the song says, who sacrifices her own happiness so that her child and her children could be happy. That is what the earthly mother does. Just imagine what the universal mother would do for us. And so at times like this, we are reminded as children who have lost our mothers of that emptiness. On a day like today, we feel the sense of loss and sadness, and it brings not a tear, but many tears to our eyes. We feel that sense of loss. As I sit here this morning from the Krishna Mandir and I look at the empty benches, I see very clearly in my mind all of the wonderful, powerful mothers of this Mandir. The mothers who are not here physically. And if I were to call all of their names that I was tempted to do, we would be here for most of the morning. And I think of the wonderful contribution that they have made by their example, by their work, by their inspiration, by their joy, to groom successful, holistically developed, productive children. I think of all of the mothers who function now in this Mandir, who continue that legacy and who make invaluable contributions not only to their families but to society. Times have changed. Mothers no longer reside solely in the home. They are no longer only homemakers, but they are leaders. They are leaders in business, they are leaders in education, they are leaders in farming, they are leaders in all aspects of our society. And they have done so and continue to do so with distinction. Without them, our world and our lives is a much poorer place. And so we must pay tribute where it is due. And a day like today, where it is set aside, we do indeed pay tribute to all of our mothers. But how do we do so? With Panditji Olin's stores closed, we can't buy our mother a fridge. We can't buy our mother and mix our iron. Our mothers don't want those things. What do our mothers want? Well, she wants me to make lunch. That may be so. What she really wants is your assistance, not for you to make lunch. What she wants most and foremost is your love, your time, but most importantly, that you learn from her example, and that you too, whether boy or girl, man or woman, shine as an example of what a mother means and what a mother has taught us. Mothers most and foremost want to see their children happy, want to see their children being healthy, want to see their children being peaceful and being successful. And make no mistake, being successful does not mean the type of car that you drive, the type of clothes that you wear, the type of house that you live in, or the type of job that you hold, or how many zeros at the back of the numbers of your bank account. That is not what it means to be prosperous. What it means is to be happy and to be productive, contributing members of society who ourselves make a difference for the benefit of others. And that is all that mothers really want. When a mother blesses her child and says, "I bless you, my child," that is the greatest gift you can get. And it is really tragic when a mother must shed a tear or several tears because their children have gone along a path of deviance. Always strive to be the children who would evoke the blessings of a mother, and never the children who would provoke the tears. This morning, my few words to you, really focus on how we pay tribute to mother. And I say to all of us who are children of earthly mothers, more so all of us who are children of the Divine Mother, that we should live our lives in such a way that we are contributing, productive persons persons who uplift others, persons who uplift ourselves and our families, persons who do the right thing always and not be persons of a different ilk. Do not compare yourself to anyone and say or think that that person is doing more. Always remember that your best is always good enough. I repeat that. That your best is always good enough. Always give of your best. This morning, as we pay tribute to mothers present, to all of our beautiful, wonderful mothers who are no longer here, and indeed to all of our mothers who are trying so hard to cope with the effects of loss, of challenge, of all kinds, of sickness, of the uncertainty that is currently prevailing us, let us ask for the blessings of the Divine Mother. Let us ask her to bless us individually, and let us be firm in our faith, in our Shraddha, that that universal, compassionate Mother, compassionate that she is, ever present, she is always within us, that we will allow her light and her energy to shine through, that we will act as instruments of that Divine Mother in uplifting ourselves and in uplifting others, especially in these challenging times. What should we do, brothers and sisters? We should try to make ourselves stronger. Stronger mentally, stronger emotionally, stronger physically, but most importantly, we must try to make ourselves stronger spiritually. And once we are able to do that incrementally, it will not happen overnight, but we must be on that pathway to those successes. And once that occurs, then not only will we be more powerful in ourselves, in all aspects of our life, but we will also be more powerful to assist those around us who are in need of our help at this time. Let us now turn our attention to the Divine Mother. As we focus on her form and as we engage this morning in a few moments of meditation and in a few moments of prayer, I invite you, if you are in your puja rooms, to gaze at the Murti of the Divine Mother before you. For those of you who do not have that benefit, look at your screen, whether it's on your cell phone, on your laptop, on your desktop, on your television. Look at the image, the icon of the Divine Mother here and on there. That exudes that divine energy, that peace, that compassion. And sit upright wherever you are, sit comfortably. As we listen to the strains of the Bansuri, let us fix our eyes on that peaceful countenance of the Divine Mother. Look at her face, smiling, peaceful, serene. Close our eyes now, and let us pray to the Divine Mother. Let us worship her. Let us perform her puja. Let us seek her blessings. Breathe in deeply. And as we see, we chant Om, and we do so three times. She holds the various weapons. lying prostrate before her with her head touching the lotus-like feet. And with the tears from her eyes gently flowing down, garland her with beautiful petals, flowers, and marble. And we hold in our hand the most beautifully decorated Hali, with that dear burning resplendently as we offer to her that marriage.
thank you. We pray for the removal of all difficulties.
Uplift your children, O Mama. Restore them to good health. Remove from our lives this predicament that we find ourselves in. Relieve us from sorrow. Relieve us from struggle. We pray and pray again, O Mama, for the benefit of all of humanity. You, O Mama, Mother and Father, you are family, you are friend, you are knowledge, you are wealth. You are indeed everything to us. We surrender ourselves completely to you.
Jai Devi Maya, Sitaram everyone. See you all next time. Jai Sitaram.